long drive.
Ma'am, where are we?
We are the most famous museum in India.
Why is this museum famous?
This museum is home for many historical items, and now we are here to explore. Enough doubts. Now let's get into the museum.
People in these paintings.
And what did the people in these paintings do?
The people present in these paintings are freedom fighters. They are the reason why we are practicing the right called freedom.
These people in the paintings are the roots of freedom for India. They stood up high into the sky to win freedom. They were ready to sacrifice their lives for the betterment of India. These fighters strive day and night without rest to see the bright smiles on people's faces.
Subhash Chandra Bose was born in Cuttack on 1897, 23rd January. Young Netaji was very eager to attain freedom of India. He did not want others to experience the problem his parents did. He got inspired by his great parents Janakinath Bose and Prabhavati Bose. He has topped the examination of Calcutta and graduated with the first class in philosophy of Scottish Church's College. He left his civil services midway to return to India in 1921. Bose lived with a vision and inspired a lot of people. He founded an Indian National Army called Azad Hind, or the Provisional Government of Free India, and helped bring freedom to India. Bose motivated the troops with his fiery speeches. His famous quote is, "Tum mujhe khoon do, main tumhe azadi dunga." Subhash Chandra Bose is considered as the most influential freedom fighter with extraordinary leadership skills. Bose is the reason why we have a standard and perfect army. He has inspired a lot of youth and molded them into young, brave comrades. Bose died of third-degree burns, which he suffered in a plane crash in Taiwan on 18th August 1945. However, many in India refused to believe that he died. Many inquiry committees were tasked to finding out what happened on that day. The Fijis report and the Shah Nawaz committee concluded that Bose died in a plane crash in Taiwan. The Khosla commission also concurred with the previous reports, but the Mukherjee commission said that Bose's death could not be proved. This report was rejected by the government.
Ma'am, is she also a freedom fighter?
Yes, she is Jhansi Lakshmi Bai. Her character is the synonym of bravery and the antonym of treachery.
Rani Lakshmi Bai was born on 19th November 1828 in the town of Varanasi. She was named Manikarnika Tambe. She was affectionately addressed as Manu. Manu's mother died in childhood. Manu's father used to work with Peshwa Sahib of Bitur. The Peshwa Sahib raised Manu like his own daughter. He named Manu as Chabili. From childhood, Manu started learning about using weapons and also she became proficient in horse riding and fencing under the guidance of Nana Saheb and Atya Top. Rani Lakshmi Bhai seated in the hearts of every Indian lover. Without knowing about Rani Lakshmi Bhai, knowing about Indian freedom struggle does not complete. Many Indian leaders fought against the British rule in India for many years. Some showed bravery and courage, some sacrificed their lives in the sake of getting independence. Rani Lakshmi Bhai was one of the leading warriors of India's first war of independence, who laid an outstanding influence on the succeeding women freedom fighters. Rani Lakshmi Bhai was a symbol of bravery, patriotism, respect of girl child, perseverance, generosity, and resistance to British rule.
Oh, an interesting story. It is even so hard to imagine India without freedom.